I
Oh,
think
look at
Tato will
this.
pick Aztecs.
This is completely backs you with Aztecs and Tato with Mayans. We'd just be completely fooled then. If anything, I would have seen it the other way around if it was going to be Aztecs versus Mayans. So it looks like we're going to see Bakti going for the sort of very aggressive Siege Monk style. And Tato
Right.
may end up on the defensive slightly in this game.
I really think that in an Aztecs versus Mayans, it comes down to early Imperial Age, if the Mayans can get there, okay, or late Imperial Age when the Aztecs just own. It's when can Bakhti get the siege on Aegir's, then just flip the game on his head.
Yeah, well, speaking of that, look at Bakhti's map. It's the least
Oh
vulnerable map
my
I've ever seen.
God.
There is just no way that Tato can apply pressure to his resources. Like he would have to defeat Bakhti before he could deal with this map. I mean, what is this?
He has two relics inside his base. I mean,
Oh, I didn't
oh
even
my
see. I hadn't even
God.
noticed that because I was too busy staring at the gold. Two relics inside his base. Four back golds,
You know, he
and
could just sit inside,
he could
boot
sit.
to Imperial Age, make siege on Aegir's, and win. His map is
This
that good.
is the best map I've ever seen on Arena. Like, two relics inside your base and four back golds, and then they're not even sort of back golds that if you got into the base a little bit, you would actually have to defeat Bakhti in order to do any damage to these golds. And meanwhile, Tato, forward main gold. It's not terribly far forward, but forward
If there
secondary
was
gold.
ever a time for a
Two.
Hail Mary to be thrown
Yeah.
for Bakhti to win a game, like, this is just one of those.
Oh
I mean,
my
like,
God. If
wow.
Bakhti can lose this, it has to be a legendary fault.
Yep.
I think I
We'll quote
can.
that.
Yeah, he does need a legendary fault.
Dark Age not going so clean.
Yeah.
Got one unavailable by that wood line. I mean, I'm very, very nitpicky, but but I have to be. Look at this map. It's
Yeah,
stupid. Oh God, I feel sorry for Tato when he sees his game. I mean, but let's go concentrate Tato's map right now. He's got a very forward main goal, actually close to that. Not so close, but fairly close to the walls. A secondary goal too, being the same thing. Has got. The good thing though, as mains, is that stone, and he has got two, the main stone and the secondary stone at the back of the map, and his third gold too, so. Not terrible, but I mean, when we're looking at Bakhti, this is just biggest, just such a difference, I can't believe it. Oh dear. Anyway, back to our professionalism. It's
Sorry, guys. I'm just
points-wise.
having a little bit of a struggle because I'm
It's
ill.
fine.
I was just going to say, can you watch on 50 speed just so that you don't get ahead of me
Oh
again?
yeah, I'm on.
I'm on.
Yeah, I'm at 5:10.
Yeah, that's perfect if you stay on 50
All right.
from there, okay.
Yeah. All right. Cool. Stay on there then. So relic position wise, actually, well, of course, two in Bakhti's base. One actually not too far from his secondary stone, it seems, as well, by the stone gate. So that's pretty good for him too. And the last two, well. Somewhat in the middle of the map, but a
Pretty
little
much
bit closer to
contestable for
Tato.
the other relics. I mean, it's not impossible that we can see Bakhti get five if he pushes out with monks early in the Castle Age, especially if
I
his
wouldn't
uptime
blame
is
him.
faster.
I mean, he just has to put, the monastery, doesn't have to bother picking up the first two inside his base. Just go out and pick up the rest of them, and before picking up his own two, because those two are already secured for him, so it's fine. And of course, with Aztecs, you can get disgustingly faster Castle Age uptimes, of course. Like, we're talking. I've seen Eddie do, what, a 1350? Which is. I can't believe I've ever seen that, but I have. Confirmed. But, we'll see what Bakhti can do here.
Guys in the chat, I know that the map isn't everything, and in fact, it's definitely what the players do in the game that decides it the most. But at the first few minutes of Arena, certainly the first 3 or 4 minutes, the map is something to look at, isn't it? Because
It's like that way where I know the map isn't everything, but it's like starting a game in easy mode and medium mode and difficult mode and hard mode. Something like that. map does make it a lot easier to take advantage of. And Bactri's map is something which it's not just taking advantage, you can literally abuse it.
Yep. I'm definitely true in that case, of course.
I mean, you can literally abuse that map. You can just sit inside your base and boom. Not be much aggressive. Get through that early Imperial Age where Mayans are just like the unstoppable force. And then get the Siege on Aegis and become the immovable object.
Much right there, that's for sure. Oh, actually, it looks like Tatos picked up two sheep of Bactis, actually. Mag 2, I think.
Yeah, I just got a little confused there because I thought, oh, he's back to scouting with his own sheep, but then I just realised I was mentally getting the colours the wrong way around.
Bacti first looking up.
Bacti's at this moment is not aware of the possibility that he could quite easily get all five relics if he pushes out more heavily in the Castle Age, because he hasn't found the one that's right next to his stone. He's missing that by a tile, and he hasn't found the one on the far left.
And we've... he does not have his eagle anymore, right?
Yeah, I just somewhere amongst all our talking about the relics or something, he's lost his scout in a fight with Tatos. I don't know where, though. Their body was being cleaned up now.
I just have a quick look for it, but I can't see it either.
No, whoops. Whoops. Whoopsie.
Sorry, guys. Three pairs of eyes and we didn't see it. But Tato's just going to lure Deer now because he knows he can do that with back scout on the map, not on the map, and there's only so much scouting information you can gain on Arena for at this moment. It's best to just lure the Deers in. Deer!
You were crazy like me the other day for doing it, but now you have.
I think...
Well, if you look at Bacti's scouting, actually, he hasn't got barely anything done. He's done his own base.
Yep.
But all he sees is the third extra, you know, the third relic on the map, which is
between
the base. So actually, not actually a lot covered there. Market blacksmith. Yep, standard stuff. Now, what's he got? 200 gold. What's Tato doing? Has he got any on stone? Yeah, he's got 3 on stone, so he's going to go for that castle, of course.
Do you expect he'll put a defensive castle? I hope, for his sake, he doesn't try and castle drop back to you because...
Well, with Mayans, you don't particularly want to go for aggressive play castle just because of the fact you want to keep them alive, especially for the later game as well.
Get some plumes out and take map control.
You'll play it defensively. You'll put it near his main gold, probably on just the the right-hand side of it, maybe.
Yeah, you would expect so.
Near towards the gate, most likely, and then pump them out.
Tato's actually going to wall in the relic in the middle, so I think he's expecting Bacti to go heavily for a smush, and he's not going to contest that with units of his own, but he's just going to try and deny the relics from Bacti. And of course, knowing that Bacti lost his scout early, if he can, he's free to do out and move out and do this whilst Bacti's advancing to the castle edge, because Bacti's scout can't find out that he's doing it or attempt to deny it. So it's quite an intelligent move from Tato. And since he's going for a castle build rather than a monk build, he knows that he's going to be second to the relics if that's what Bacti chooses to do.
Bacti's actually got the barracks down. He's going to get some eagles out, I'm sure, just to try and obtain that map control. And pick up all those relics, but... But them all being, with all them being walled up, not sure that Bacti would get to access any. Maybe one, actually, I think. Tato's not quick enough.
The thing is that for all Tato is doing this, Bacti can still take two relics as they're inside his base. And two relics with Aztecs is pretty nice. It's almost like having three with any other civilization. And because Tato's laming these, he's obviously signalling his intention isn't really to go and take them anytime soon, so... Bacti will still have a nice bonus of two relics with the Aztec gold bonus and relic gold bonus as well. So, for all Tato's efforts, he's not going to be denying too many relics to Bacti in that sense. Even though, obviously, having five relics would be quite disastrous if he allowed Bhakti to take five. So it's definitely still worth it. But, you know, if the map generation in terms of the relics had been and favoured Bhakti so much, then Tata could very well have got out and walled up all five relics if they'd been in the middle. Bhakti producing at least one more eagle just to get some more scouting information, because he hasn't yet scouted Tato's base, and he hasn't been scouting at all since, well, quite early in the feudal age, I think, or even late dark age. But he's continuing to produce more eagle warriors, double monastery, so he's pushing out in an attempt to get the relics, but obviously that's Tato's denied that for now.
Well, Tato's up into the castle age right now. He's jumping a castle right now, but only building it with two villages so far. That's like we can maybe afford to do so, but
he's coming with a four, I think.
But yeah, but I think you're absolutely right, because about the walling of the relics, and he's not in no real rush to get this castle up, it seems. He wants to go up to the castle, get a few plumes out, and get like three TCs going.
I still think that Bhakti should have gone at least for a mini boom, because at this moment, Tato is the one going for the mini boom, and he's gonna have a better economy in early imp, and that castle is going to deny Bhakti from entering his base very easily. So if this game goes into the early Imperial Age, where most meso wars are decided, then Tato is going to have a ridiculous advantage, I would say. Because, with no offense intended to any Eagle Warrior, plumed archers, elite plumed archers, do completely destroy plumes.
In that critical mass, I think you're absolutely right with the plumed archers. I mean, you know, with the Eagle Warriors, I think in this early part of the castle age, for sure, plumed archers definitely do when fully upgraded, because Eagle Warriors are just too weak then. But if it gets later on, like, it's all about that space and where they are, when the plumed archers are positioned. Like, if the Eagle Warriors can close them down and, like, circle around, then
it's like a breaking point where Aztecs have, like, a 30-second window in early Imperial Age when elite plumed archers don't exist and don't have enough upgrades. And after that, elite plumes are just rampaging through the arena. And then it comes down to the next window where Mayans has, like, I would say 7-8 minutes to push its advantage before Siege on Agers destroy everything.
Yeah, right. Well, just then it looks like Tato tried to venture out, but it looks like one plume did get converted, and now that Bhakti knows, Tato knows what's going on, he's like, okay. Looks like I gotta get back now. It's not gonna work out too well.
Yeah, there are way too many monks out there right now. And scorpions and rams. Tato could be in trouble here if he's not able to hold.
In trouble. I actually make a small mistake though. He's trying to get to that relic, but he's going through the wrong stone wall. He should have gone to the left one. It's on half HP, but take nothing massive, of course.
Yes. That's fine, I think.
Look at the position of the house and everything that the Tato's done on the left-hand side near the castle, yeah. Of course, making that small partial wall off. And we're playing some cheap walls too. Wait, herbal medicine just got completed by Bhakti? I'm not even kidding. I genuinely think herbal medicine was just completed. Let me go and check.
I mean, I don't know, because I haven't watched many arena games to know if that's very common. But
why? Why did he get unless herbal it was medicine?
The thing is that we saw in that engagement just one of the monks would have gone down but it was being healed by the other monk, and because with just three or four plumes shooting at it, that was enough to kind of outheal the damage, and well, not necessarily outheal the damage, but keep the monk alive for a little bit longer until Tato ran back because one of these other plumes got converted.
Do you know what herbal medicine does?
It's not the healing speed, is it? It's the garrison one.
Yeah,
isn't the garrison
units
one?
Garrison,
oh yeah, apologies. Sorry, yeah, I was thinking it was healing speed. Like actual monk healing speed, yeah, you're right, you made me realise.
That's why I'm laughing.
Okay, I shall laugh with
you,
sorry.
350 gold. I think he wants to get redemption.
If that's another misclick, then it's not in the line of misclicking and deleting his castle earlier. But yeah, sorry, I've confused the monk technologies.
No, it's fine. I just find it hilarious that got herbal medicine. Fought back tea. I think he's probably really nervous, probably, the fact that, you know, it's like deciding game basically for him if really continues or not. Fought back tea. I love him. Alright, though. See how he. Still no defensive siege workshop coming out from at all from passive, actually. Probably expect that he's worried the fact that, you know, the redemption coming in, that it'll get converted and also. All those ratty rounds as well. Okay, now a siege workshop comes down, but a bit too late, I think.
Yeah, I mean, he's been aware for quite a long time that Baxi's preparing to push him and to go aggressive, so you'd have expected to see that a little bit earlier, but he is going to try and do a counter raid with petards and bust into Baxi's walls. Well, he's not doing it yet, but he has the petards. They've just jumped back into the castle, so I think he's going to concentrate on defense for the moment, because I think he's realize that this push is massive and he can't afford to push out and try and raid Baxi, of course, otherwise he'll lose everything at home. But this is a very precarious position for him at the moment. So many monks and batting rams in there.
He does do a good job, a good idea actually, against batting rams. They do a very good amount of damage, but just not enough of them really. Maybe?
Yeah, I thought his original intention was to use those to bust in at the other side of the map and raid, but I don't know if maybe he made them originally to defend anyway. Maybe that was his choice.
I think it's a bit of both, really.
They started moving towards the top left, so I thought they were going to be used for raiding, but they've actually worked out really well in terms of they've whittled down the number of rams to a number that he can deal with.
Why is it actually these monks aren't just going? I think they should put them a bit more aggressive, but it's going to lose with things, and these batting rams haven't paid off. It hasn't actually killed the castle. Brought it down quite a good amount of margin, but
I think it's paused again.
Yeah, another pause too. Big push though. Where does Tato even go from here? I mean, he's defending okay for now, but looks like Bakhti's changed tack. Forget the castle, let's go for the eco instead. Get rid of that house. But oh, look up. Tata's gonna fix that hole up. There's a couple of bills to conversions though.
Oh, oh my god! Holy hell!
Oof. That was good.
He's gonna SMB. Get through again.
Yeah, sorry, I'm just having
redemption,
a
redemption, redemption. Oh, redemption!
Oh man, that was some good mang shots there, but it's like most of these monks are a cooldown in their conversion.
Yeah, many of them are recharging at the moment, so they're going down, but.
Yes.
Another hole in the wall once more. It's like the batting rams punching on through. But look, literally, Baxi just going full out in, but look at the field count. There's 10 difference. That's nothing, really, I don't think. Considering the amount of villager idol really spent time from Tato, so crazy.
I don't think I like where this game is going for Tato, because if that castle falls, he's gonna be dead.
Yeah.
Maybe he should take a leaf out of Bakhti's book right now and just wall between the mining camp and the gate on the right with some extra gates.
Oh, and that's a lot of battering rams. That's a lot of battering rams.
I mean, if he just did some gate walls, as put a couple of mangonels behind.
But yeah, there we go. He could just not even care and go and take the TC out.
Focus the mining camp, I think, first, and then take that out, and then go straight to the castle.
I think I wouldn't even go for the castle and just take out the TC.
That's why.
Kill everything else.
Well.
Who cares?
He's gonna convert the siege block.
Oh, he's
gonna
convert it.
Really nice.
Oh my god, this is.
Yep.
Yep, he's converted it.
Oh no.
This is gonna kill everything else. You keep your castle. Oh, petards!
Yep.
Look at the number of petards being massed. Oh, and now he's gonna go for the castle. Do petards do AoE damage?
Yeah,
I think a very tiny amount.
Look at that, he killed about four rams, that's actually not a bad job. The problem is, though, is the fact that they're just suicide units. Like, he can't keep them, so he makes them and then they're gone, and then he's got to, again, keep making them to keep up.
And yeah, and you need return on investment. Oh, and he's converted the mangonel as well.
Oh.
Okay, this is not going to be good. That, another hole punched in the wall.
Please,
convert
the P-Tug.
Oh, and this game is going to... Oh, Tato's put up another castle!
Where?
Yeah, he's been building it in the back since a little while ago. But and his Imperial Age is on the way.
Oh, he's going imp, but this is not going to be good. Oh, but he's building eagles. I don't think that's going to work, especially with like 300 gold.
Yeah, he's completely took off his main goal. He has got that second goal he's been using, but look how much gold he's got left. You know, only about... just under 2,000 gold left.
I don't think he can mass enough eagles to do the trick here, personally. Oh, but suddenly he has 800. I think he can. And eagles will just turn the game on its head again.
Yeah, he just sold 500 stone to do that, though. So sacrificed a lot of stone, really, considering it's mains, but... gotta try and do it.
Back to even with a forward tower to try and deny Tato's farming is quite... amusing.
I love it.
Seems like you're necessary, but he just loves putting up the towers. One annoying plume in the woodline as well.
Not actually a bad idea. I mean, it's nice to do that just to secure it, really, more than anything else. I mean, look how many farms that Tato's got currently active. It's only like, what, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9?
Yeah. And Tato's scared of those batting rams coming in and denying, so he's trying to quick all the castle, but it'll be fine.
Less of the battering ram and more of the monks. Tato might not have any villagers left.
Yeah, at this current rate, that's for sure. And look, Tato's just like everything in villages to kill rams with. Oh, God.
And Tato now with fewer villages than... well, the same amount of villages than Baxi, despite having been on 3 times since for most of the
castle age. Oh, bunch of monks, eagles coming in. This is... oh, my God.
Be huge. We'll see how this goes down.
Oh, my God.
Bird is coming in.
Oh, no, this is not going to be good. This is disaster.
Yes.
Disaster
for
who?
I think most of those monks have got their conversion capacity, though. I can only see a couple that are on recharge, so it's really going to...
Put the monks in the tower! Put the monks in the tower you built!
Yeah, he's still losing them all.
Oh.
I think Tato just won the game.
Yeah, Tato's going to be able to clean all of this up now. He's actually 10 villages behind, so he doesn't really have the economy, but he does have the Imperial Age, and that's the crucial thing, whereas I assume Bakhti still only... I mean, he can potentially buy his way up to Imp, I guess.
Look at his resource, he's got no food but 800 wood and 1,000 gold. I don't think it's over just yet.
I think it's quite premature to say that Tato just won this game, but...
because Tato's got no upgrades on those eagles, he's got none. Not a single one, so...
oh my God, you know. Normal eagles are stronger than them right now.
I don't think so.
Kind of are with those upgrades. Well, one upgrade. Nothing really, it's just numbers game right now.
Yeah, more of a numbers game, I think.
No, but Tato has Elite Eagle.
Yeah.
Yep. It's gonna come down to the numbers game here. And...
I don't understand how Tato... oh, it's because Eco's probably better. Actually, no, the military. If you look at the KD, Tato's killed 113 units and lost 71. Bakhti's killed 33 and lost 113.
Yeah.
That's a lot, actually, considering in terms of numbers.
A lot of the things, the kills that Tato's picked up, though, will have been his own units that he had to get rid of. So it's not like Bakhti's just... lost the resources from all of those deaths that he's sustained, if you know what I mean, because each monk probably converted multiple units during its lifetime. So normally if you see a KD like that, it means one player's taken a horrendous hit to their economy in terms of the resources spent to what they've actually gained from it, but not really in this case when Bakhti's monks had been so effective up until that point.
Iron cast is coming in for Tato right now, and then these eagles are a lot more upgraded right now than Bakhti's, which is now becoming a big problem. He says monks to convert, and there we go. Here come the monks.
I didn't see.
Wow, look at the military now. 45-7.
Yeah, Tato just lost a lot there.
And look at back T, you just took in the main gold of Tato. He's like, I'll take that, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Oh, I love him. Looks like some four bills from Tar trying to stop that gap, but instead, actually going to lose a couple of conversions here.
I think this game is still extremely in favour of Back T, to be honest, because Tato's out of gold now. So,
yeah.
Yes, Back T, with all the relics, he's going to be winning this game quite soon, I think.
Well, he's also got another gold mine, another stone mine, all of the gold that Back T, that he took from Tato. Three relics that are inside walls. He's got a lot of shit he can use till now.
There's still two relics unclaimed in the middle, but Bakhti's had two in his monastery for most of the game, picked up the third. He's claiming all the gold mines on the map, and Tato's not. Well, he's got two gold mines that have got 100 gold left between them, so does he have a bank left? No, he doesn't. He's only got 200 left in the bank, so... Yeah. Pretty much, Tato's down to trash at this point, and eagles are obviously ridiculous trash killers, so...
I think Bakhti has enough eagles right now to just go straight through.
I think the game is effectively over. Tato will try to defend this, but he really has no hope with that number of siege and monks versus only about 15 eagles for Tato that can't really be replaced.
It's just looking pretty bad here for Tato. If people talk about his scores being reflections of the games, it's just not one of these cases. Like, he may be, 2,000 score up, but definitely not what we're seeing here. Crazy.
Oh my god.
And here we go. Yeah, it's just... Not good. I'll tell you, it's not a game I would have expected, to be honest, considering the map backs he had. But I like it though. It's much more interesting.
I think that he picked Aztecs because he wanted to execute this strategy regardless of what happened, but it just so. The map generation meant that if he'd have been unsuccessful with his push, he'd have been able to fall back and take resources safely without Tato pushing out and countering him with it. You know, so it basically gave him an extra chance to stay alive in this game if his strategy didn't work out. But I think this was intentional all along. The civilization choice would reflect that.
What Back T really needs to do though to really finish it's starting to build inside and Tato's base. I mean, it's taking so long for all those rams and monks to get over. He needs to start building more inside the base to keep the reinforcements coming at this point. I mean, he just start buying the resources. He's got 3,000 gold. Just, you know, buy a bit of food. Wood, food? I said food twice. Food, wood.
I'm trying to see what Tato might think that he can still do in this game, because I don't want players to call GG whilst they still feel that they have a chance, but he's got 5 eagles and no gold and down to 46 villages, of which many of them have been idle for quite a long time, and he's just rebuilding another town centre, but I don't see how he can feel that he could reboom in this corner and sort of push out again when he knows that Bakhti's just got control of the whole map and could have all of the relics if he just beat down these walls. So maybe he's just trying to play a few little mind games in the context of the whole series and just try and tire or frustrate Bakhti a little bit. I mean, he's not going to get tired doing this, but maybe just frustrate him a little bit, thinking, why is this guy not resigning? I don't know. Just try and decrease his concentration slightly moving forward. But I think this is just a question of waiting for Bakhti to GG. Sorry, Tato to GG.
I don't know, I don't think so, because the fact that Tato literally needs one more game, if I was him, like, okay, this game's over, let's just quickly move on to the next game and you know, basically win that one. I don't think he's going to try and frustrate or tire him out, because I think he wants to get wants to wrap this up. So Tato's not that sort of person either, I don't think, either. He's quite a far the opposite. You'll call it GG when he says it. He actually put the third town center up, so maybe he's applying the motto of when in doubt, macro it out. And but probably not going to save him, though.
But Bact is just massing for the kill now. He's bringing in more and more rams. And I think once he's got a couple more, he'll just push in and end it. And he's actually walling Tato into the map to prevent any shenanigans, although Tato doesn't really have the production or economy to, or even a way out of his base to engage in any shenanigans, sort of like getting into Rex's base. And it also means that Tato can't sort of sneak out and find any resources anywhere. So
Back T is such a monster. He doesn't care about TCs. He's still on the one TC power play. It's like I'm not gonna bother making any more TCs. I'm just gonna even make snowballs out. It's just constricting the flow. I like that. Just for the next engagement, those eagles can't like wrap around or whatever. It's nice. I like that.
And Tato about to lose both trebuchets.
Yeah.
So.
What are you doing? What?
He was under fire from two non-elite plumes in the castle. I'm sure those eagles can tank a little bit. He might have lost one, but it's worth it to kill both trebs. Tato has mangonels as well to defend against the rams, so he may be able to take these rams down, but the eagles will just run in and destroy the mangonels. And then
the monks will convert them.
Yeah.
There you go, one conversion
then
ready.
He's going to have about 30 eagles and 30 monks in his economy, so at that point it's over. Well, it's been over for a while now, but
we'll see.
The push that ends it.
Yeah.
Tato's just laughing with the 11. GG, well played. It seems like, I think Bakhti enjoyed that game and is laughing a little bit at Tato's futile resistance.
That was amazing.
that was
a great play.
Quite a fun game. I think that the civilization choices had a big effect there on what strategies the players wanted to go for. I mean, I was saying that Bakhti probably would have done that regardless of what map he got with Aztecs. But I think if Bakhti had gone Mayans, we may well have seen him trying to boom it up with that map he had. But it seems that he definitely wanted to play aggressive. Obviously collecting ridiculous amounts of gold compared to Tato. He controlled all of it.
Be three times as much. And the conversions as well. 59 units converted in the end as well. Even though the KD was just terrible in his favour, he still won. It's like, I don't care how many punches to the face I'm going to get, I'm still going to beat you down.
Back to even with the villager high, despite 1 TC versus 3 TC.
Amazing. Just like those villagers conversions. He's like, I don't need 3 TCs, I just need monks to take the bills for me.
But Back to